Joining us now, ranking member of the Committee on Oversight and Government Reform, Democratic Congressman, our friend, Elijah Cummings of Maryland. Very good to have you this morning.
Good morning.
You know, Casey brought up a point that while all this is happening, and it seems like, you know, Democrats can figure out how to get out of their problems, and they have a lot of work to do. Republicans are digging in the dirt, and we're electing certain types of candidates. And then we have Puerto Rico.
Yeah.
And it just seems to me that at some point somebody could be talking about that. Somebody could be doing more about that, including Hillary Clinton, who's extremely critical of President Trump.
I
Go
agree.
To Puerto Rico. Bring your book tour to Puerto Rico. That would be impressive. Yeah,
Elijah.
The response has been anemic. Back when we had Katrina, I said to the world in a news conference, God would not be pleased with our response to Katrina. God certainly wouldn't be pleased with this response, and I'm saying to President Trump, you need to quadruple your efforts, and you need to have a coordinated Department of Defense response to this. It's estimated that we need at least about 50,000 troops there. Even after Haiti, we had 20,000. So there's a lot, and it seems as if you're talking about 3.4 million American citizens. Mr. President, we can do better than this.
Yes.
And I know you said that everything is going well, and I'm hoping that you're listening, but they are not going well. All you have to do is listen to some of the local officials down there, and they will tell you that people are literally dying. Hospitals do not have energy to run generators, food, water. These are American citizens. Treat them as American citizens, just like we treated people in Florida and Texas.
Congressman, it's Willie Geist. It's good to see you up and looking healthy this morning. We're happy to have you on the show.
I am so happy to be, I'm happy to be seen.
How are you feeling, sir?
I feel real good.
Good, good. Well, I want to ask you just to get your take on the news overnight we've been talking about. It's the race in Alabama where Judge Roy Moore won. What does it tell you? Does it tell you something about Alabama, or does it tell you something about where national politics and the midterm races are headed, that a guy like Roy Moore, with all the positions and beliefs that we just laid out, was able to win that race?
I think basically what has happened is that Donald Trump, our president, has laid out the foundation for the Roy Moores to emerge to be able to win races like this. In other words, although President Trump was for Mr. Strange, the fact is that Roy Moore probably is more akin to Donald Trump than Strange. And so I think basically that this climate has been set. And on a slight detour from that subject, let me say this to Joe and Mika. Yesterday, I listened to you all very carefully as you talked about the president with regard to his comments concerning John McCain, the negative comments that he gave, that the president gave. And I applaud you all for raising those issues. Here's a man who gave his blood, sweat, and tears, and lying now in the eve of his life. And yet and still we have a president that goes around beating him up. That to me is unconscionable. And so if people want to raise concerns about patriotism and honoring the flag, well, how about somebody who basically laid over 5 years fined as a prisoner of war, beaten, tortured, and yet and still the president said that he has no respect for a soldier who gets caught. Come on now, we're better than that.
Much better than that. Elijah Cummings, thank you so much.
Thank you, Elijah.
For being with us.
He looks good, doesn't he?
Yes, he
does. Looking good, and would love to have
bless you, friend.
Would love to have you back in the next day or two to talk about the Russia investigation that really, in a real sense, you launched
Jared's emails
with a letter way back in the fall. Thank you so much for being with us.
Thank you.